Good morning, presidents. Thank you for being here with us. My question is for Chancellor Gallagher. I am a Pitt alum from 2003, and I'm very proud of my Pitt education, and it has brought me here today. So building on what my colleague said across the aisle, something that I was concerned about in 2003 and something that I am concerned about now is the safety of college students. It has come to my attention that three speakers who have crossed the line of free speech over into hate speech, targeting transgender students and the transgender community, they're coming to campus, coming to Pitt's campus beginning this Friday. One of them saying essentially that transgender people should be eradicated. So, Chancellor, you're allowing them to come on campus. How does this keep transgender students safe? How does this keep LGBTQ plus students safe at my alma mater? And how does this align with the values, the stated values of the University of Pittsburgh and its commitment to diversity, inclusion, equity, and, you know, making sure that it's an inclusive place for all students?
Thank you, and thank you for representing with the Pitt colors today, I noticed. So.
I mean, I do look good in blue and yellow. Blue and gold, sorry.
Well, Representative Mays, as you and I have spoken about separately, you know, this is one of these issues where multiple values of the university are getting taxed at the same time, and it's one of the most challenging acts, I think, in higher education. So it is certainly the case that diversity, equity, and inclusion are vital parts of a university, because we cannot carry out our mission if every member of the institution doesn't belong there, have rights to belong there, and is free from discrimination and bias. And in that, you know, in that context, we fully stand with all of our students, including our trans and non-gender conforming students, who have a lot of concerns about this. We understand the concerns, and we agree that a lot of the rhetoric that is happening both nationally and potentially will happen on campus is enormously problematic for them. The other part of this, though, is that the university is a place of dialogue. And in fact, both constitutional and academic free speech are things that I'm obligated to support, which means that many of the rules governing, in this case, extracurricular activities by registered student organizations has to be applied independent of the content of the events. And so we are doing that. The safety of our students is, you know, never a question here, even in these difficult times. So guidelines that the university has for the conduct of events, for the conduct of protesters, for the conduct of speakers, for the host, for preparation, for consulting, are all being used, and we will continue to do our best to navigate this very difficult arena. But the one thing that makes this very challenging is there's a tendency to want to define what the university stands for by who's allowed to speak on the campus, and therein lies the problem that as soon as we do that and apply that basis, then in some ways we're also undercutting the very purpose of the university in the same way that undercutting diversity, equity, and inclusion. So it's almost like these two values look like they're in tension, but I sort of view it as, you're right, they're in tension, but if you cut the rope, you know, they're both less stable. And so they're actually values that reinforce each other. I understand that it is at times when the speech is most repugnant, that these values are the hardest to uphold, and we're doing our best to make sure that we support the rights of our students, our faculty, our staff, and our community, while at the same time upholding their rights of expression and to invite speakers and to do this. And as I told you, it's still a dynamic situation. We'll continue to keep you and others who are interested apprised of.
Well, from here, as the representative, and Pitt is part of my district, I certainly echo my call for you to cancel the speakers who are coming to campus. And I stand with the almost 11,000 students and supporters on campus who have asked you to do the same. Thank you for your time.